Hello everyone, welcome to India Defence Institute Daily Current Affairs. So let us see some of the important current affairs of today. The first one is Digi Saksham. Recently, the Union Minister for Labour and Employment has launched this Digi Saksham portal. Yes, which is a digital skills program. Yes. So India has been, you know, improving a lot of the skill development by means of PM Kaushal Vikas Yojana, Deen Dayal Kaushal Vikas Yojana, all these things. So specifically in the digital platform, the skill development, we are using the digital platform. This Digi Saksham has been started. And you can see the main aim is to enhance the employability of the youth by imparting digital skills that is required in the present day digital world. So this initiative is jointly with the Minister of Labour and Employment along with the Microsoft India, okay, is doing this extension of this government ongoing programs to support the youth from rural and semi-urban areas. Yes. So we have this initiative. It is a free of cost training in digital skills, including basic skills as well as basic advanced and also advanced computing. And you know, they are planning to give it to nearly 3 lakh youths in the first year. Yes. So the priority will be given to the job seekers in the semi-urban area and the disadvantaged community and the people who lost their job because of this COVID pandemic and all. Yes. So there are 3 types of training that is provided under this initiative. One is digital skills, self-paced learning, yes, on learning on its own, VILT mode, virtual instructor-led mode, and ILT mode, instructor-led mode. So 3 modes are there. Yes. So in this ILT mode, in-person training will be conducted at Model Career Centers, MCCs, and the National Career Service Centers, NCSC, for the SC and STs across the country. Yes. So nearly, okay, 1 crore active job seekers, okay, on this National Career Service. So this NCS, National Career Service, it is a portal maintained by the Ministry of Labour and Employment to help the people, okay, to help the people, the employable population in India to get employment. Yes. And they will be given access to this area like in JavaScript, data visualization, advanced Excel, okay, HTML, programming languages, all the things which are basic requirements, okay, to survive in a digital economy. Yes. So the implementing authority of this Digi Saksham is Aga Khan Rural Support Program India. Yes. So that will be implementing agency. Yes. And they are planning to equip nearly 3 lakh youth in the technical skills, as I told you, in the first year of this specific initiative. So NCS portal, as I told you, it is a job seekers can assess the training. So the job seekers, to improve the skills of the job seekers, they can improve their skill set by, okay, installing them, by, you know, making them as a member of this National Career Service portal. Yes. So the Ministry of Labour and Employment is implementing agency of this portal. Next is FinTech in India. So recently, the Union Minister of Commerce and Industry, okay, while addressing the second global FinTech Fest, told that at 87%, India has the highest FinTech adoption rate in the world. So FinTech is a blended word of financial technology. So all the, so when you are using technology for finance-related things, okay, including using ATM card, online transaction, Paytm, BIM, credit card, debit card, point of sale machines, everything. So for all financial-related matters, filing IT returns, everything, if you use technology for financial things, that is called FinTech. And India is rapidly adopting this FinTech at nearly 87%, highest adoption rate in the world, compared to the average global average of 64%. Yes. And the investment flow will, okay, has gone up to nearly $10 billion since in 2016. Yes. And also India is promising to be one of the, okay, fastest growing FinTech markets with 2,100 FinTechs, financial technologies. Yes. So it is currently valued at $31 billion and, you know, the growth is expected to be nearly $84 billion, around $100 billion by 2030. Yes. So the government also recently launched, you know, the, as I told you, the FinTech solutions like credit payments, accounting, tax filing, all the things when you use digital technologies. Yes. Open credit enabling network and, you know, account aggregator framework, all these things are also part of this financial tech. Next is ONGC Videsh Limited. Yes. So the ONGC Videsh Limited has begun this exploratory drill campaign in Bangladesh. So the ONGC Oil and Natural Gas Corporation is one of the Maharatna company of Government of India. Yes. So ONGC Videsh, it is a, okay, external company. For example, the ONGC Videsh Limited will go and sign a deal with the foreign countries to explore the energy security, to impart energy security to the country. Okay, for example, ONGC Videsh Limited has stakes in Vietnam and also in other countries. Yes. So you can see a wholly owned subsidiary, which is a company of ONGC, Oil and Natural Gas Limited. Yes. And it has started its first well, Kanchan, okay, in block SS04 in Bangladesh okay, which is in the okay Mahesh Kali Island. So for oil drilling, for energy security, so India should not be relying only on one country alone. It has to diversify its imports. Then only in case of any sudden shock or in case of any, you know, economical disruptions among the country, among the world, okay, the India can absorb the shock. So that is why the diversified investment has been done. And ONGC Videsh Limited, okay, is spurring, is aiding the India in diversifying this kind of investments. Yes. So the oil well is planned to drill up to 4,200 meters. Okay, and you know, this has already, you know, started. Yes. And it will be followed by true drilling at two more locations. Yes. So this ONGC Videsh Limited, along with the OIL, Oil India Limited, okay, they are allowed to have, okay, they have given the license to explore this offshore block SS-04 and SS-09 in Bangladesh during 2012 itself. But because of the COVID and all, it was delayed, and again it has started. Yes, it is again one of considered as one of the strategic move by India. Next is Indian Astronomical Observatory, IAO Hanle. Yes, so this astronomical observatory, which is located at Hanle near Leh in Ladakh region, okay, as becoming a very important, you know, astronomical site across the globe. Yes. Why? In the sense, it has a lot of geographical things, okay, geographical and climatological things to support it. You can see it has more clear nights, minimal light pollution, background aerosol concentration, extremely dry atmospheric condition, and uninterrupted monsoon. Because of the high altitude in Ladakh, Leh region, generally Ladakh and Leh, it is around more than 2,000 to 3,000 meter high than MSL, mean sea level. So the cloud cover is very less, the air is very thin. So there will be no clouds, it is very clear. And that is why, okay, also very less pollution, and this region is not, you know, affected by monsoon clouds and all. So that is why it is posing as a apt location for observatory. So the night observation at Hanle, okay, by this 2 meter Himalayan Chandra telescope are possible throughout the year without any interruptions due to monsoons. Yes, because of the high altitude. Yes, and they have carried out the detailed study of the nighttime cloud at nearly 8 high altitude observatories, including 3 in India. So what are the 3? We can see in Hanle and Merak in Ladakh, and Devasthal in Nainital. So these are the 3, okay, important Indian astronomical observatory in India. The next is SAGE project. Yes. So SAGE, it is a portal for the senior citizens. Yes. It is a one-stop access to elderly care products and services. Yes. So this has been, you know, the SAGE is the acronym of Senior Care Aging Growth Engine, SAGE. Yes, it is started by the Ministry of Social Justice and Empowerment. Okay, and what is the aim? Simple, promote private enterprises to bring out innovation in products to benefit the elderly people for the elderly care, geriatric care. And this is based on the recommendation of Empowered Expert Committee, okay, for the elderly. Yes, so the Interministerial Committee for the Senior Citizens Welfare Fund, SCWF, they are about to fund this, okay, nearly 100 crores equity support for the startups with maximum of 1 crore per startup. So this startup, okay, after the fund for the startups will be taken from the Senior Citizen Welfare Fund, and it will be invested, and the startup will create unique products, okay, unique products for the elderly and for taking care of the elderly and the geriatric care. Next is Sacred Portal. Yes, so the senior citizens working, okay, seeking working opportunities, yeah, they will be assisted by the Sacred Portal. Yes, so this portal again is developed by Ministry of Social Justice and Empowerment, and Sacred is also a acronym of Senior Able Citizens for Re-Employment in Dignity, Sacred. Yes, so the people who are above 60 years of age, okay, can register on this portal and find jobs and work opportunities. Yes. So it will be like an enabler, okay, it will just enable you, and it will not guarantee any employment, but just it will just enable you to find the employment. Yes. Next is Expert Committee on Sustainable Finance. Yes. So the International Financial Service Center Authority, IFSCA, it has constituted an expert committee to recommend approach towards development of sustainable finance hub. So this committee has been chaired by the Sri K. Mishra, okay, who is a former Secretary of Ministry of Environment. Yes. And it also contains leaders from all of the arena, you know, of India, important, you know, finance mechanism across the world. Yes. So this IFSCA, yes, International Financial Service Centers Authority, it has been established as a unified regulator to develop and regulate fintech products, financial services, and financial services. Simple. International Financial Center, IFSC, is nothing but to cater the needs of international financial system. So if any person want to avail the services of a bank in USA, he doesn't necessarily have to go to USA. He can go to the IFSC in any country, and from there they can avail this. So Singapore also has this international finance center. So like that in India, it is GIFT. So this GIFT IFSC is there. So it is Gujarat International FinTech City. The GIFT city is there. In that only this International Financial Service Center Authority.
Yes.
So it is a overall controlling regulating authority of this International Financial Service Center. So it will regulate all the activities. As I told you, the main aim is to act as a global hub for sustainable finance by acting as a gateway for channelizing foreign capital to India. Simple. That is what. So if any person, if a foreigner want to come to India and have to invest, so this IFSC will serve. Okay, it will serve as a good mood, and it will encourage them to come easily, okay, invest money, and it can increase the capital flow inflow to the India. Next is report on best practices in the performance of district hospital. Yes, the NITI Aayog has recently released a performance audit assessment of district hospitals. So they have assessed how the district hospitals across the country, okay, they are performing.
Yes,
so it is based on the collaboration with the Ministry of Health and Family Welfare, WHO. Yes, and also the National Accreditation Board for Hospital and Healthcare Providers, which is a okay one of the constituent board of Quality Council of India, an autonomous council for, you know, for withstanding, for making the standards, okay, quality standards in India.
Yes.
So this is such okay first ever such performance assessment, okay, which is carried out on the ground.
Yes.
And it covers nearly 10 key performance indicators, and nearly 707 district hospitals across all states and UTs have been okay. They have involved in this specific assessment.
Yes.
And the health management information system, HMIS system, this has been used as a basic data.
Yes.
So overall 75 district hospitals, okay, across 24 states and UTs emerged as a top performers.
Yes.
So the performance is based on, you know, availability of beds, you know, oxygen beds, availability of oxygen, medical paramedical staff, core health drainage testing services, lab testing services, and other, you know, transport services, everything, okay, it will be covered under this performance assessment. So based on this only, how much a district hospital has to be catered, how much investment, and how much, you know, this enhancement has to be done to the district capital will be later on catered. The next is AMRUT 2.0.
Yes.
So the AMRUT is nothing but Atal Mission for Regeneration and Urban Transformation. Yes. Already AMRUT 1.0 has been going on, and okay, PM Modi is going to start this AMRUT 2.0 on 1st October at Dr. Ambedkar International Center, New Delhi.
Yes.
So what is the main aim? Simple. AMRUT is nothing but a holistic development of urban area. A urban holistic development. That is called AMRUT.
Yes.
It is this smart city scheme. AMRUT is the basic. Okay. AMRUT is like foundation, and smart city is above the foundation. So the aim is to provide 100% coverage of water supply to all households in the nearly 4,700 urban local bodies, and 2.68 crore tap connections, and 100% coverage of sewerage and septage. So both sanitation as well as water connection. By giving nearly 2.68 crore tap connections and 2.64 sewer connections.
Yes.
Underground drainage system and also drinking water, okay, tap system.
Yes.
And you know, it adopts the principle of circular economy. Means, okay, it has to be circular. It shouldn't be a linear one, rather circular one. For example, okay, if the water is used for any purposes, again it has to be recycled back into the economy. Rather, okay, it will be sent to the ocean or any natural water body to dump. So this is called circular economy.
Yes.
So what is my name? Simple. Promote conservation, regeneration of surface and groundwater bodies.
Yes.
And also, it is a data-led governance in water management and submission to leverage latest global technologies and skill.
Yes.
It is full of data. So Digital India will also aid this AMRUT 2 to improve its character as data-led governance in water management.
Yes.
So this page all survection, yes, it will be a campaign to promote aggressive competition among the states. So the ranking will be given based on how, okay, which city ranked the most.
Yes.
And the outlay, the total budget of nearly 2.87 lakh crores. Then is Swachh Bharat Mission Urban 2.0. Yes, Clean India campaign. Again, the Swachh Bharat Mission Urban 2.0, second version, will be launched at the same time and at the same venue, Dr. Ambedkar International Care Center.
Yes.
So what is the main aim of this, okay, Clean India campaign 2.0 urban? Simple, make all cities garbage free and ensure gray and black water management in all cities other than those covered under AMRUT.
Yes.
So gray water, it is water from the, you know, this urinals, and this black water, it is water from the toilets. So it is called gray water and black water. Yes. And also, you know, so this management of all cities, so make all cities garbage free. Generally, there is a lot of categories are there in this, you know, Swachh Bharat mission. You can see ODF and ODF plus. Generally, ODF means open defecation free. Okay, no one should go, okay, this restroom and toilet outside, okay, except for a bathroom. That is called ODF. And when it is called ODF, so most of the, you know, urban areas are ODF free, ODF cities. What is ODF plus in the sense? Okay, the all the toilets should have water, proper hygiene and maintenance. If it has, it will be promoted as ODF plus. And ODF F plus plus, double plus means, okay, except for water, presence of water, hygiene and management, and also sewage and septage management has to be there. Okay, so ODF plus means a toilet having proper water supply, okay, good septic tank, you know, this pipe system, and proper removal of this septage water. So all together will be called as ODF plus plus. Yes. So it make all urban local bodies as ODF plus, and those with the population less than 1 lakh as ODF plus plus. So gradually they are increasing the standard. Yes. And what is the main focus? Yes, it will focus on source segregation of solid waste, reducing principle of 3R, reduce, reuse, recycle, scientific processing of all types of MSW, municipal solid waste, and remediation of legacy dump sites. Legacy dump site in the sense, okay, the dumping in a particular region for a long time, okay, for 10 years, 15 years, that is called as legacy dump sites. Yes. Simple, it not only cover, okay, about, you know, putting, you know, garbage in the public place, but also talk about regeneration, okay, and recycling of this dumping sites. And this is the Swachh Bharat Mission Urban 2.0. So the total outlay is around 1.41 lakh crore. So as you can see, all urban local bodies have declared open defecation free. And nearly 70% of solid waste is being scientifically processed now. But still, it is not enough, and India has to go further more. So that's all about today's current affairs. So let us come up with more informative and interview current affairs tomorrow. Thank you.